मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेक यू टू अ वेरी सिंपल चैप्टर ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, दैट इज मनी एंड सप्लाई ऑफ मनी. एज वी ऑल नो टुडे दैट विदाउट मनी वी कैन नॉट एक्सचेंज एनीथिंग इन द मार्केट. Or we cannot buy, we cannot sell. So money is one of the most basic requirement of mankind. But let us see that earlier, before money was being came into existence, how exchange was taking place and what was its drawback. So we go. This is chapter number 4 of macroeconomics, which I am again telling you it's money and its supply. I am taking you to the next page, that how evolution of money took place. Evolution of money took place in our history long time back, where money was minted in the form of metallic money, in the form of gold, silver, and which was used for exchange. And why it was used, we know that because before evolution of money, there was a system which was prevalent in the market. And today, before moving further about the use of money, let us try to understand that how a system was being existing before evolution of money, and we go to that, and that is called barter system. Barter system, exactly if you come to its term, is about how the people used to exchange goods for another goods or goods for service. Like, for example, a person is a carpenter, he is giving his service and he wants a bag of wheat, so he has to exchange that from a farmer. So that's the way a service was being exchanged for a bag of wheat, or bag of wheat was exchanged for a piece of cloth. So barter system is basically the exchange of goods for goods, or for goods with service. This was before the evolution of money. But now in this barter system, you have certain drawbacks. The first drawback is lack of double coincidence of wants. Let us try to understand what does this drawback mean. For example, a farmer producing wheat is in need of a piece of cloth, and that piece of cloth is made by a weaver, and farmer is ready to exchange his wheat to buy the cloth, but the weaver is also ready to exchange his cloth, but not ready to exchange his cloth for a bag of wheat. He wants a bag of rice maybe. So until and unless two people are not ready to exchange their commodity with each other, that is the first drawback, and which is called as lack of double coincidence of wants. And I hope you, many of you, are having your books with you. You can read this part, that how two people are ready to exchange their goods for another good, or their service with another good. But if this two people are not agreeing to exchange their goods with each other, then that is the lack
or drawback or barter system, which is called as double coincidence. That coincidence should be from both the side, that one is ready to exchange his goods for another one, and another one is ready to exchange his goods for another person goods. So this is the first drawback. We go to the second drawback, that there is lack of common measure of value. In barter system, it's very hard to measure one goods for another goods or one service for another service. It's very simple, like that if you want to buy a bag of wheat for how much of cloth, it's not possible to measure that how much bag of wheat will you be able to buy with how much piece of cloth. So that is another problem of barter system, that is called lack of common measure of value. Today, when you have money, we know that how much piece of cloth can be bought by what price of money, or how much bag of wheat can be bought by what price. But at that time, because the evolution of money was not there, so this is the second drawback, which is called as lack of common measure of value. The third drawback of barter system is lack of standard of deferred payment. The meaning is that in barter system, when we exchange goods for another goods, and if we want to pay the payment of that goods in future contract, then it is not easy to calculate that what could be the payment or what could be the exchange of quality and quantity of goods in the near future. So that is the third basic drawback. Example, that if we buy something today and we want to exchange the another good after a period of time, then what could be the exchange of another good? Because after a period of time, maybe the quality and quantity of certain goods get varied, get changed. So that is again a big drawback in the barter system. The fourth drawback is lack of store of value. Because when we want to store a certain goods, for example, if we want to store wheat, it requires a big place. But if the same wheat is being sold in the market and we store that value of wheat in terms of rupees, it is much easier to store. And when we store this value in the form of goods, it requires a lot of place. And maybe after a period of time, it can be spoiled by rats, insect, and the value of that goods can completely go down. So that is the fourth drawback of barter system, that is lack of store of value. Because the commodities can be completely spoiled or lose its value after a period of time. The last drawback of barter system is about indivisibility of commodities. For example, a person who has a cow wants to exchange the cow for another good, but the another good is quite less in amount, so he cannot just divide the cow to get the value of another good. So there are many products which cannot be divided, or divisibility is not possible. In money, you can have the smallest of currency to the biggest of currency, but that divisibility is not possible, especially in the animals or many other products, because if we divide, the product loses its value. So that is the fifth drawback of barter system. Now, after understanding the drawbacks of barter system, we are able to understand the value of money in the market. And with the function of money, all these drawbacks have been overruled. Or we can say that money is helping us to overcome the drawbacks of water system. So if we go to the next level to understand, there is function of money and it's been divided into primary and secondary function. To understand the primary function, the first basic function of money, that money is been used as medium of exchange. Whereas we saw that in barter system, goods could be only exchanged for goods or service. In money, and that the biggest problem of barter system was double coincidence. In money, it becomes quite easy for everyone to exchange his service for money or his goods for money, because it's very easy and everyone is ready to accept money, because the same money will help him to buy another goods or service. So it is a primary medium of exchange. It helps in purchasing and selling, and all goods can be exchanged for money. Whereas in barter system, we saw that there was a drawback because of double coincidence of wants. So that drawback has been overruled by the first primary function of money, that is medium of exchange. It is a common unit which is acceptable by all in the market. No one can say that they will not accept money for exchange of goods or service. The second primary function what we find is the drawback what we saw was measure of value, and money becomes a common unit of account, or it can be measured very easily. It's a yardstick of standard measure of value, whether you want to buy good like wheat or a meter of cloth or oil, all can be easily measured with money. So calculation is possible with money, and that is called measure of value. Now we go to the secondary function, that money can be paid as a future contract or money as deferred payment. For example, you buy a good today and you want to pay in installment in some period of time. So we know that you have to pay the price of the good plus the interest of the months you are paying in installment. So it becomes easy to calculate that how much the price of good and how much the rate of interest together you can pay in future. So that drawback is overruled again, because money is easily can be calculated as future payment or as deferred payment. The last important secondary function, that money can be easily used as store of value. The store of value means that if you sell your goods, it's very easy to convert into money and keep it in your house, safe in the locker, or you can deposit in the bank, there it becomes safe, or you can deposit or you can invest that money somewhere else. So that becomes, it's an easy to store as value. If you carry some notes with you, that is much easier to carry than to carry your goods. So that is the fourth drawback of barter system, which is overruled with evolution of money. So today you had seen the drawbacks of barter system and how money evolution has overruled the drawbacks of barter system. So after this, we will continue with further of this chapter with more forms of money in the market today. Thank you. Have a good day.